In the time between Tomb Raider releases, it's sometimes a good idea to see what entries in other franchises can scratch that specific Tomb Raider itch. Often, only one game in a franchise might have similarities to Tomb Raider, and even then, there will be gameplay elements that are utterly dissimilar. But regardless, the following are all great games, so no low-end rip-offs will be featured. This is in no specific order. Indiana Jones and the Infernal Machine is probably the most shameless and blatant ripoff of Tomb Raider, specifically classic Tomb Raider, but that doesn't mean it's bad at all. May as well copy from the best, right? Its level design replicates classic Tomb Raider's non-linearity and actually expands upon it. The levels are even bigger, would you believe? And often, they're even more ambitious. The core gameplay, pun intended, is identical to early Tomb Raider with its intricate temples and tombs, its running and gunning, its running and jumping, and its environmental traps and hazards. The similarities here are self-evident. If you're more into old-school Tomb Raider, then this really is a must-play because you'll be right at home with its familiar balance of combat, exploration, trap dodging, and puzzle solving. Special shout-out goes to Indiana Jones and the Emperor's Tomb. This is also very much a great and worthwhile comparison to Tomb Raider, but the level design is much more simple and linear than found in the Infernal Machine. Assassin's Creed Unity actually harkens back mostly to the Angel of Darkness, I think. Thematically and atmospherically, Unity always gives me strong Angel of Darkness vibes. They're both primarily set in Paris, they both have plots that explore ancient societies still at war in the present day, they both feature ancient historical spaces, they both have a rich cinematic style, and they both have freedom in jumping and climbing, although significantly more in Unity's case. Even circumstantially, there are similarities in that they were both overly ambitious and released in an incomplete state, except Unity came out in the days of patches, so has been fully fixed to a perfectly playable state. Don't let the reputation of its shocking launch dissuade you. You should know that the actual moment-to-moment gameplay and missions are very different to Tomb Raider's, but there's definitely more than enough overlap between the games for it to qualify for this list. So if you like the action-adventure genre and Angel of Darkness's themes and aura, then you'll like this. Prince of Persia: Warrior Within does non-linear level design at such a high standard. Backtracking has a bad reputation, but it's handled extremely well here. You regularly travel to and from the past and the present to see areas change through multiple time periods as a means of circumventing diverse obstacles all throughout a huge gothic island castle. In the present, there might be a mechanism that no longer works due to its age, so you have to travel back to the past to activate it when it was in working order. Or in the past, there may be an obstacle in your way that has fallen away over time, so it can only be crossed once you time travel to the present, where the path has since become clear. As well as this kind of very carefully crafted and fine-tuned level design, Prince of Persia: Warrior Within has some of the best trap runs I've ever seen in gaming. I mean, look at this, why the fuck can't we have that in Tomb Raider? Other similarities include puzzle solving and fluid traversal, which Tomb Raider Legend definitely took inspiration from. This game is impressively inventive, it radiates a strong, moody visual atmosphere, underlined with a high-energy heavy metal score, it has stylish freeform hack-and-slash combat with ample options, it has a genuinely captivating multi-layered story with quotable dialogue and unexpected turns, and is personally one of my favourite games ever. Whilst there are heaps of similarities to Tomb Raider, if you like gaming at all, play this. Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order is a game that I can strongly recommend even though I'm not really into Star Wars at all, which should say something about how good this is. Its overall structure is most similar to Survivor Tomb Raider, where it's Metroidvania style. It has hub areas with multiple branching paths, some of which are locked until you progress and get new gear and abilities, opening access for the critical story path, as well as secret hidden areas. Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order has really nice movement, platforming, and traversal controls. It just feels solid and consistent to control, which is so important, so it nails that fun factor. Without spoiling anything, the traversal abilities as well continually open up throughout the whole runtime, giving you more and more options, which mixes perfectly with the deep, large-scale complexes you explore. Fans of Survivor Tomb Raider should appreciate this for its similar pseudo-open world structure, its upgrade system, and its gear gating. As a bonus, unlike Survivor Tomb Raider, this is actually written and acted well. Broken Sword, the Sleeping Dragon. You know how in Angel of Darkness, in Parisian Ghetto, you talk to different people to unlock conversational topics with other characters and then go to them to proceed? This game is like that part, but massively expanded. The caveat here is that the moment-to-moment gameplay is the most dissimilar to any Tomb Raider compared to other entries on this list, such as jumping and climbing is very restricted and contextual, so it's more storyline-based reasons as to why it's here. You do still solve puzzles and go to age-old underground sites that are magnificently striking, and there are still action elements and some basic traversal, but most of the time, you find items, examine them, investigate areas, and ask nearby people questions to get new leads to move forwards. The themes here are very resemblant of Angel of Darkness because it also, like Assassin's Creed Unity, deals with dueling ancient cults that you get entangled with. It's mainly set in Paris and has a large scope ranging from ancient manuscript decryption to modern day serial killers to powerful ornate artifacts. So if you're really into the story side of Angel of Darkness, you should find this similarly captivating. Uncharted: The Lost Legacy is the most obvious and predictable entry, which is why it's last, but that's not to say it doesn't fully deserve to be here. Of all the Uncharted games, I selected this one not because you play as a female, who, may I just say, Chloe Fraser is nothing like any version of Lara Croft outside of her being into treasure, but because it's the most non-linear of the Uncharted series, offering the most freedom of exploration and having the lowest volume of combat encounters. It's got a hub system akin to Survivor Tomb Raider, but it's got that more light-hearted classic Tomb Raider vibe. It has a really organic sense of exploration and discovery, with some of the most dazzlingly spectacular environments I've ever seen in a game. If you like classic and Survivor Tomb Raider, then you'll like this for its expert marriage of those two styles. It is highly recommended. So those are my picks. There are of course going to be lots of other games with elements that are particularly similar to Tomb Raider, but these are the ones I've actually played and can personally recommend. It's worth mentioning in the comments what other games you think are similar to Tomb Raider so that others might discover something new if they take a look. My name is Seth, thanks so much for watching.